Aries, welcome to the Onyx Moon Tarot. Like, share, subscribe, and comment. Go to my Facebook page, The Onyx Moon. Follow and like for a daily pick a card. Your oracle message is Island Time Wellness. There is no gender in tarot. This is something that could have already happened to you, could be happening to you now, could happen to you in the future. I could be pulling on your sun sign, Aries, your moon, or your rising. If you know your moon or rising sign, let me know. I could be pulling on cross-watcher energy as well. And if not, then I'm just not hitting it for you this time. And that's okay. You can tell me that I'm not resonating with you. I don't get upset about that. There's many, many Aries in the world, and I just might not be hitting it for you. And I do not get offended when you say it's not for me. Curse, hex, witchcraft, negative mind. Okay. So... not going to say that it doesn't happen. You have to feed into that. You have to feed into that fear, and you have to have that mindset of being fearful. And we aren't victims here. We're nobody's victim. So even if somebody would put that on you, say those words on you, if you walk in the light and you have faith, you know, in the name of Jesus, amen, none of that matters. It's going to roll right off of you. That has no place in your life. I didn't even know that card was in there, which I don't take cards out of decks like some readers do. But you have faith in Jesus' name. You have no fear of this. Negative mind, now, somebody could have a negative mind, and they can be doing this. They can be doing a hex. They can be doing witchcraft. They can be sending you negative. Somebody can send you negative vibes. You're doing really well in life, and they just keep putting out that hate, that hate, that hate, that hate. They can do that, absolutely. Not realizing that everything that they put out against you, if you're divinely protected, it comes back against them and hits things in their life. And then their life is going to shit and they don't understand. That's why they're more jealous of you, because your life, it looks even better and their life is going to shit. And then they get more upset and then they do more hateful things. It's just like, stop. Leave me alone. Go live your life. And don't be jealous. Don't be jealous of the Aries Collective. So yes, people do things like this. But in Jesus' name, amen. You know what? They say they are legion. No, you are legion. In Jesus' name, you walk in the light. You are the chosen. Not the nonsense that these people want to. And if you really feel that this has happened, you can go to my YouTube, to my Facebook channel, The Onyx Moon. You can DM me. I can tell you how to do a return to sender, a spiritual bath. I can tell you how to do things to protect yourself. Or you can just not feed into the fear and know that you walk with spirit and that you are one of the chosen and you don't have to worry about any of that. We don't walk in fear because we're nobody's victim. Not enough. Frustrated in a relationship. Lack of confidence, self-sabotage, fear, ego issues, jealousy. All right, so that plays along with this. This person has issues. I'm going to say that right now, okay? They're insecure. They can't go out and get themselves someone. Not the Aries Collective. They can't go out and get themselves someone because they're not enough. They have to be propped up even by themselves because they lack the self-confidence of being whole. So that is why they want to do the dirty. That's kind of sad. Ascended Masters, Archangels, Holy Spirit, guides, please. Aries Collective. And quite frankly, an Aries is probably the wrong person to be playing with like that. Because The ram that don't give a damn. Aries will throw hands. Aries takes no shit. I know, my mama was an Aries. I'm going to lay these cards out and then we're going to talk about them. This is very similar. All right, Aries. Okay. Somebody is, I'm not going to say you, them, put this how it, wherever it goes. Somebody is researching, paying a little bit more attention to somebody else's business than their own. Access to social media, being able to drive past somebody's house, going past somebody's job, going to the place they get their coffee, talking to mutual friends. Somebody is spying, researching, being nosy. That irritates me. You want to know something about me? Use your words and ask. Doing that sneaky shit? Yeah, not for me. I think they're doing this because they feel that you've moved on. You've turned your back. You've moved on. You could have met someone at work. Or you could be very focused on work. All of your you think that it's possible that you think work is where you need to focus. You may think that work is, they may have told you that work was going to be, your job might have been presented to you one way and you see it as something else. It may not turn out exactly as how you think it's going to be. You may see it as something that it is not. I'm not saying that's a bad thing. I'm just saying that it may not be what you think it is. If you see, I can't show you the entire card. Eight of Pentacles is all about being at the top of your game, the pinnacle, the master of your craft, and you're raking in the money. You are at the top, okay? If you're going to be, if you're in the, a lawyer, an attorney, you have just made partner. This is your top dog. So this person is painting pentacles, okay? But what he's looking at to paint is a naked woman. So he's looking at his model, but he's not seeing a model. He's seeing a star. So you may be thinking that this job is the be-all and end-all, but that's not what it really is. So it might be you that did the spying, it might be you that did the research, something, or somebody spying on you, and they are seeing you walking away and putting all of your time and effort into your career. And you may think that it is solace to you, and it really is not. Getting your mind off of whatever happened with this person, and it's really not. It's just, it's like a placeholder. It's a placebo. Nothing wrong with making money, but that's not healing you or getting you over whatever happened. You may hear from this person. They may reach out with a little, I don't know. If you have kids in the same, they go to the same school, same sports, something very, very small. Maybe you're passing each other, picking up kids, dropping off kids, same sport. You're going to hear something very, very small. Or you could hear something about their child, or this person is very childish, and you're going to hear something about them that is very childish, and you won't be surprised. You're holding back. You're holding back where you should spend. And by that, I mean everything. You're sitting back and you're deciding where you... So maybe it is you that has done this research and this spying. You may think this person is too immature for you because you are holding back. And you are trying to determine, where should I spend? What is worth the effort and time and energy of where I should spend my time, my money, myself, my energy, my love? You're trying to determine where, because I think you feel this person is, it's a Nine of Pentacles reverse. This person is lazy, a non-starter, a quitter. They don't have the same work ethics. They don't have the same get up and go. They don't have the, they're not working like you. You're at the top, and this person is at a stalemate. Like, maybe they lost their job and they're just not getting another one. And you're like, I'm not carrying anybody. So you have the, you close the door. As far as you're not, I don't think you're considering this person. You want something that has balance. Could be Sagittarian energy. This person, you could meet somebody with Sagittarius energy. You could have Sagittarian energy in your chart. You want balance. You need patience, but you want balance. You're not going to have anybody in your life that's wishy-washy. I can't make up my mind. I want to go here, but I want to go there. I don't know what I want to do. And that's what you have with this Knight of Pentacles reversed. And Temperance is balancing things. This is not giving you balance. So Death card is slamming that door shut. That door is shut. I'm moving forward and moving on. And what are you moving on to be? I'll tell you what you're moving on to be. You're moving on to be the Queen of Pentacles. This is Earth energy, but that does not mean that you cannot exhibit the characteristics of the Queen of Pentacles. Doesn't mean that you're Taurus now. You could have Taurus in your chart, but you are exhibiting the characteristics of the Queen of Pentacles. The Queen of Pentacles is very practical, very concerned with stability. You can rely on her, consistent, reliable, can handle everything you throw at them. They have the job, the work, the housework, the kids, their husband, everything is impeccable. It's done. They make it look easy. They are also very, and I'm really thinking this Page of Swords is you. They are also the Mrs. Kravitz. They're freaking nosy. I mean, it's Taurus energy, but they are on their phones. They're nosy. They know everything about everybody. And that's kind of, when it's reversed, it's worse. But they're gossipy. So if you're doing that, kind of watch what you're doing there. But it's not a good look. You are leaving this person out in the cold. They are going to feel, or they do feel, left out, shut out, on the outside looking in. And you're good with that. You have no problem with that. Somebody wants to curse you? Really? You're meeting an emperor. Now, this could be you. You could be in this energy, your way, my way, or the highway. You put your fist down and say, it's my way or the highway, and it could be. Or you could be meeting someone that exhibits those qualities. Stubborn, protective, in charge. Sometimes it's tunnel vision. The way they think is the way they think, and they don't like to have their thoughts challenged, their ideas challenged. They do have tunnel vision, but they are protective. They do take care of their people. It's tough being that. It's tough. Heavy is the head that wears the crown, you know? I'm going to leave your reading here, because this is a good reading. I don't know what you had going on previously, but it was enough for you to pull back and leave it. You know what you want, and you know what you're not willing to settle for. And as far as, so you're frustrated for whatever was going on, you're frustrated. And anybody that's going to be playing like this, well, return to sender. This is your reading. You know, they don't have to love us, but we'll be damned if they're going to disrespect us, right? Go to my Facebook page, The Onyx Moon. Follow and like for a daily pick a card.